I'd like to welcome you to our stand here at the Agriculture and Commercial Shows. We are exhibiting here at Jubilee Gardens together with our colleagues from the Zambia Qualifications Authority, ZAQA, from TEVETA, from ZIALI, and from the Higher Education Scholarships and Loans Board. We are exhibiting together because of our stake in higher education through vocational training and providing a quality higher education system. So we are inviting you to come over to our stand here in Jubilee Gardens, because we're giving away a lot of free stuff. You get to get some of the, you know, branded notebooks. We're giving away memory sticks. We're giving away keychains, and we're giving away a lot of prizes. But more than that, what we're doing is that we're allowing you to talk about higher education through a competition that we have. We post a video of you on our Facebook page at HEA Zambia, and if your video gets 20 likes or more, then you win prizes that we have for you. So come over to our stand. We have our officers on at the ready to talk to you about registration, to talk to you about quality assurance, to talk to you about the standards and how we are implementing our mandate. So we invite you to come down to our stand and have a conversation with us so that we can ensure that together we ensure quality in higher education. Is that okay?
Welcome to the Higher Education Authority stand at the 93rd Agriculture and Commercial Show. Here we, as you know, the theme for the show is embracing industrial development. By the way, we've interpreted it ourselves as Higher Education Authority. We are saying we are supporting industrial development through vocational training and higher education. As you know, the Higher Education Authority, the mandate is to ensure quality in our higher education institutions. And through that, we ensure that the graduates that are coming out of these institutions are of good quality and they can contribute to industrial development. I'll just walk you through a bit of history of the Higher Education Authority. We were born basically in 2013 when the Act of Parliament, they repealed the then University Act to usher in a Higher Education Act. That Higher Education Act provided for the establishment of the Higher Education Authority. I think government saw it fit that they introduced the Higher Education Authority, because we saw that there were a lot of institutions that were being created without a body or an institution to ensure quality in these institutions. And that came about in 1999 when the government repealed the 1990 Act, University Act, to provide for private sector participation, because it realized that we had so many secondary school graduates, but very few tertiary institutions to absorb those graduates. So they allowed the private sector to participate. But at that time, there was no institution that was ensuring that these private institutions were, you know, following quality education and providing quality education to our people. So it was created for that purpose. So far, but in terms of actually implementation of the act started in 2015. And since then, when we started in 2015, we found about 35 institutions operating already as private universities that were actually registered by the then Ministry of Education. So we created tools for us to register institutions, benchmarking with South Africa, Australia, and Bangladesh. These are Commonwealth countries. And then we started registering them. By 2018, we had about 58 institutions registered, including the 35. Although out of 35, because they were requested to re-register, two of them did not make it. But as of 2019, we have 60 higher education institutions registered. I must say that half of those are providing distance education, basically ODL. So you don't expect big campuses like UNSA, because some of them are doing ODL, and half of those are also doing face-to-face. apart from registering higher education institutions, the authority is also mandated to accredit learning programs that these institutions are offering. And we started that exercise in June 2017. So far, we have received about 972 programs. And we have evaluated about 800 programs, of which 300 have been accredited. We have rejected about 131 programs because there are a lot of things. In rejecting, we also look at, first in accreditation, we look at the content of the program. Who is going to be teaching? Are they qualified? The infrastructure in which that program will be offered. The support in terms of learner support, the financial support, and then when you look at that, if the program qualifies or meets that criteria, then we accredit. And after accrediting, we submit the program to Zambia Qualifications Authority, who then registers that as a qualification. So that's their role, to register qualifications. So that program, that exercise is still continuing. We have estimated about 2,000 programs that are being offered in this country, in various institutions. And so far we have evaluated the number, it said about 800, so we have a long way to go. And ultimately, the public may think that, no, we have so many institutions in this country, but the important thing is to ensure that the programs that they are running are of good quality. That's why we use experts. Depending on the program, we look for experts who look at the content, they evaluate, they even visit the institution to talk to the lecturers and the facilities that are there before they recommend for accreditation. So that's our role, and in doing that, we ensure that the products or the graduates coming out of this system are of good standard, so that we support industrial development in this country. In addition, we don't just end at registering institutions or accrediting learning programs. We do what is called auditing. In auditing, we go back to the institutions after some time, depending on what we found. Sometimes we can go back after 6 months or 1 year to check whether they are still following the criteria that we agreed upon when they were registered. For the programs, we still want to find out whether the lecturers, they said, were the ones going to teach the program, are the ones that are teaching, so that we ensure that the quality that we agreed upon at accreditation of learning program is maintained. So that is auditing. We also have inspections. Inspections can be spot inspections, where if we know that there's something in that institution, the inspectors can go there and check, so that all these activities are towards ensuring quality education in our education institutions.